Hi, welcome to an Inventor 2018 video tutorial. I did this crankshaft before in Inventor as well, and I wanted to show you a different approach which could be useful for some other exercises or projects or whatever you want to do. So let's have fun with Inventor 2018. The first steps are very similar to the older version. So let's go for a sketch, and I will do almost all my sketches there, and I will use this for the first one. And let's check it. Let's see our axis. That's X, that's Y, that's okay, yes. So this would be first a circle, and diameter would be 80. Okay, and this should be aligned like this. Okay, so horizontal vertical is swapped. This happens. It's kind of annoying, but it happens. Okay. Now the distance should be 35. Then I need another circle, and this one should have a diameter of 300. And again, this one should be aligned. Okay. Then I need some lines. And this could look maybe like this. Okay. Now let's make them tangent. There should be an angle. That angle would be 40, and that distance should be 150. And let's do it with a line, construction line, from this point to that point. And this line should be, in this case it's vertical. That's kind of odd, but it is like it is. And let's align the midpoint and that one like this. And I need another dimension, but first I could trim, so go for trim. This should be removed, this one, this one. This should be removed, maybe like this. And I need another dimension. Let's see if I can do it. No, it's not possible. So I should go for another dimension. And so this distance should be 58. And I forgot to trim this. Okay, so that's okay. Now let's make an extrude with that sketch and make it 20. So let's make this visible just for reference. Okay, next sketch will be on the XY plane. I could hide this body for the moment, but not if I'm inside the sketch. Nope, that's kind of odd, so I will hide it before. Okay, and go back into that sketch. Now this profile should look something like this. Okay, this could be a center line, and these distances should be, this should be 5, this should be 5, and this should not this one, but the whole distance should be 40. This should be 56, and this distance should be 48 in diameter. Now let's move this point coincident on that one. It's fully constrained. Finish the sketch, and let's make a revolve and make it a new body and confirm. So right now these two are stacked on one another, but they're in two bodies, in two solids, so they're not joined or connected. So let's rename them. So this would be one of the counterweights. Okay? Counterweight. And this will be the small one, is one of the connecting rod journals. Okay? So I call it I will call it rod journal. Rod journal. Okay. And the intermediate main bearing journal I will call them bearing journal is the same shape, so I could use that sketch. I could take it from here, copy it and paste it on the same plane, that would be the XY plane, and just paste it. And then I could change the dimensions of this one. So make sure, yeah, that's this one. This is 40, 5.5 is the same, but those diameters will change. And that diameter would be 84, no, that's a small one, that's 76, and this would be 84. Now let's make another revolve with this sketch, make it a new body, make it full and confirm. So this would be the, what it's called, the connecting rod journal, is the small one, that's the main bearing journal, so I call it main bearing journal. Okay. Now I could hide those and now I want to do the front main bearing journal. So that would be another sketch. Again on the XY plane. And this could look something like this. Go straight over here, up. Step just close it. Now give it some dimensions. Or first change this to center line. Now give it dimensions. I will change them later to the correct values. And it's helpful if you model these bodies or solids in at least the correct orientation. So this would be 44. This would be 60. This would be 76, and that dimension would be 84. So that dimension should be 150. Yeah, this should be 5. Sorry, that distance should be 50. So it's 55 altogether, and that would be 115. And now use one constraint to put it right there. Finish that sketch, make another revolve, make it a new body, confirm. Let's call this one. That would be the main bearing channel. So main. So yeah. That's wrong. That's the main bearing channel. But I know. So I first have to rename this one, because that is the intermediate main bearing channel. So let's add one inter like this. And that would be the main bearing channel. And then I need, I'm not quite sure how it's called, let me check. And then I need a sketch for the flange. So another sketch, again on the XY plane. And this could look something like that. Okay, this should be center line, and that distance, first this should be aligned, so this should, no, this should be vertical aligned, and then I can do a dimension. This one should be 15. And this should be 25. This would be a diameter of 110, and that would be a diameter of 60. And now let's make those two coincident. Finish that sketch, make another revolve, and make it a new body. So that's almost the same, or it is the same as I did in the old version of this crankshaft. Let's call this one flange. we should spell it correct, flange. Nice. Let's make them visible. All of them. And give them different colors. Maybe the counterweight gets a blue color. Maybe like this. Yeah, confirm. The rod channel, the small one gets maybe a color, an orange color. Then the main bearing channel gets maybe some sort of more yellow color. The main bearing channel, and that's the main bearing channel, and there is something more. I give it maybe a more greenish color, and the flange could have a more violet color. Okay, so let's save this with a different name, because that name is not quite correct. This should be called the basis or base solids, and you could save it with that name as well. So I will close this one because that's the older version. And now I did it in the old version. I remained in that part and did it in this part. Now I want to make a new part. Let's save this one. Make a new part, new part. And in this part should be called, I will save it. It's sort of in winter 18, that would be part, how should I call it, intermediate part or a combo. Let's call it combo. Okay, combo. And I want to derive the bodies from the base body part, that is this one. Yeah, I really should give it a different name. Let's check. This should be called, not variant in this case, but it should be called base bodies. Yeah. So I should save it as, and give it a different file name. That would be the Inventor 18. No, sorry, I'm in the wrong part. I should go to that part and then save this one as, come on, file, save as Winter 18 base solids or bodies. Base solids, that's the base solids part. And now I want to derive that solids into that combo part. So go for derive, select the other part with the base solids, open it, and just derive all those bodies. Confirm, and now I got in this combo part all those base bodies, and these are copies of that one, of these ones, and they are connected. So if I change these, those will change as well. Now next step, I want to move these parts or solids with modify move bodies, but just noticed I need another counterweight. So I will derive the counterweight again. So I got two copies of the counterweight into this part. So I don't need these, I only need that one. So go for OK. And now two of these counterweights are in this part. Now I want to move one. So let's go for move bodies. They got no names at the moment, so I should give them names as well. So this would be, I will make an abbreviation, that would be a counterweight. I call it CV. And it's a copy, so I call it CV, and I have two, I call it counterweight copy one. So this would be the rod channel, I call it RJ, C for copy. This one, that's the intermain bearing channel, I call it EM, BJ, copy, C. Solid 4 is the main bearing channel, so I call it MBJ, and C for copy. This would be the flange, so it's a flange copy. It's kind of strange that it has not the correct color. And the last one would be a counterweight copy 2, CV C2. Okay. Now let's move CV counterweight copy 2, go to modify, move body. I want to move this body and I want to move it 40 plus 20, 60 millimeters in X direction. And I want to move the rod channel by 20. So this should be moved by 20 millimeter in X direction, and it should be also moved up by 40 in Y direction. So I could have done it with the same move body, because if you look right here, I could do the Y offset as well, so I do it for 40, and then this channel is in the right or correct place. Next would be that one. So this should be moved, not this one, but this one. So let's go for this one and deselect that one. And this should be moved 20 plus 40 plus 20, that's 80. Okay, see, all these things are in the correct place. And the flange would be somewhere in that direction. I could move it already, so go for the flange. And this would be moved in Y direction 5 times. 2 times the flange width, plus width of this one, plus width of this one, that's 5 times 120 millimeter. Take a look. So it's over there. Now I could combine these. So go for a combine. And you can keep the tool bodies. And I will put them into to wait. So this will be combined, and that's the combine, and that would be this body right now, the counterweight C1. Now that's okay, and I will do another step. I will add another part. So go for another part, new part, and this should be called, that would be the complete crankshaft in Winter 18 complete crankshaft. Now let's go for the bodies. I want to derive from, now not from the base bodies, but from the combo, from this one, and I want to have the C1 once the main bearing channel and the flange. That's okay. So I could confirm. And I got all these solids right here. So that's the combo. Let's rename this. Oh, sorry. That will be the combo. And this would be, that's of course a copy, so you might add a C. Same applies to this one, that's the main bearing channel, MBG, C, and this one would be a flange, C. And it's of course a second, a copy of a copy, but that doesn't matter. In this case, now I need four more of these, of the combos, so we'll derive them from the compo. Oh, that's compo, that's nice. It should have be a B instead of a P, so that would be the combo. Just derive it. That's the second one, derive it once more. So you got the third one again. So I made another mistake, so let's undo it, because I wanted only the combo. So derive it, go to the combo, open, and deactivate those bodies or solids which you don't want, like this. Okay, derive it once more from the combo. Yeah, composite would be okay. Deactivate. Okay. Two more. Derive from the same part. No. No. And the last one. Derive. Compo. And now that's combo C, so it's C1 in this case. So let's add a 1. This would be combo C2. Combo C2. This will be combo C3. That would be combo C4. And the last one would be combo C5. Okay. Now I want to move these. So go for modify, move bodies. Combo C2 would be moved 120 millimeters in X direction. Apply. Let's select combo 3, move it 2 times 120 mm, then go for combo C4 and move it 3 times 120 mm, and the last one, combo 5, will be moved 4 times 120 mm, 4 times 120 mm. So I got almost my complete crankshaft. What I have to do now is to rotate those combos. So again, go for the modify, move bodies command. Now just click here. If you click here, you can change this to rotate. And I want to rotate combo 2. So go for this one. The rotation axis would be the X axis. This one. Yeah. And the angle would be 144 or minus 144. I think it's minus 144. Yeah, looks good. Apply. Then go for C3. Click there. Change to rotate. Choose an axis. That would be once again the X axis. And the angle would be minus 216. Now go for combo 4, modify, move bodies, change to rotate, choose the axis, the X axis, and the angle would be minus 288. And the last combo, go to modify, move bodies, click right here, rotate, and the axis would be the X axis, and the angle would be minus 72. Now you could combine these if you want, or you could just leave it at the moment like this. Yeah, if you combine it, then go, that would be the base. You could keep the tool bodies if you want, and they're still there. So let's add the combo 1, the flange, the combo 2, 3, 4, 5, and OK. So I got one body and all the other bodies as well. So that will conclude the first part of this video. There will be a second one where I will introduce or insert the parameters, and I will do a construction table. So I will get in the end an I part. Hope you enjoyed this part. If you liked it, please give it a like. If you want to see more, please give it a like or leave a comment. Please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Please subscribe to my Facebook Cat fan page. Thanks for watching. See you to the next one. Bye bye.